It's the worst example of gerrymandering and the party of power.
These maps disenfranchise voters. They violate the Voting Rights Act, and they are in violation of numerous state and federal laws.
If it feels like you've heard this debate before, it's because you have. Every 10 years, two things happen in the U.S. The census and redrawing congressional districts. The Constitution lays out this process, stating the government must count the population every decade and, based on that number, reconsider voters' congressional districts. That is redistricting, and it happens in every state except the seven that only have one congressional district. So, who draws these maps? Some states look to commissions, but most leave it up to the state legislatures. And that's where things can get political. Let's take Ohio and New Mexico as examples. In Ohio, Republicans have control of the House and Senate. In New Mexico, Democrats do. In both states, the legislature drafted the maps and then voted on them. And in both, the minority party accused the majority of gerrymandering, or, as it's more commonly known as today, gerrymandering. That word has a long history in American politics, going all the way back to 1812 and Governor Elbridge Gerry of Massachusetts. But the bottom line is, it means drawing maps that purposefully give one party an advantage over the other. In Ohio, the state Supreme Court struck down the first set of congressional maps because the court ruled they were too partisan. And the second version is facing lawsuits. With early voting already underway, this map will probably stand. In New Mexico, the state's Republican Party brought a lawsuit challenging the maps, calling them unfair. That's how districts are drawn, but what do these new maps mean for voters? On a practical level, it means making sure you're registered to vote where you live and confirming where your polling place is. The larger consideration is representation. Do these districts fairly represent the people who live there? States haven't always abided by that. An example to remember is Jim Crow-era voter suppression, like the poll taxes and literacy tests. But states before, during, and after the Civil Rights Movement used redistricting to keep Black and Brown Americans from having their vote count. The Voting Rights Act of 1965 banned these practices outright, and anticipating how states could create new discriminatory laws, it also mandated that jurisdictions with a history of discrimination must get federal approval for any changes to their election laws. Congress voted to keep these provisions in place in 1970, 1972, 1982, and as recently as 2007. Then the Supreme Court decided in 2013 in Shelby versus Holder that the federal government overseeing certain jurisdictions' election laws was unconstitutional. Despite that decision, the bulk of the protections from the Voting Rights Act remains in place. However, states still find ways to use redistricting to keep minority communities from having fair representation. One way to counteract that, majority-minority districts, districts in which the majority of a population is a racial or ethnic minority. Redistricting is complicated, with a lot more layers than we could fit into this video, but what you can control is your vote. You can make sure you're registered in time for the 2022 election. To find out more, go to usa.gov/register to vote.